श्री गुरुचरित्र चैप्टर 12। नामधारक आस्क्ड सिद्धा, होली सर, टेल मी व्हाट द लॉर्ड डिड आफ्टर अरेविंग ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ रिवर भीमा। सिद्धा रिप्लाइड, द लॉर्ड स्टेड फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम एट गंधर्वपुरा गानगापुर, द कॉन्फ्लुएंस संगमा ऑफ रिवर्स भीमा एंड अमरजा नियर द प्लेस इज एज होली एज दैट ऑफ द कृष्णा विद द फाइव अदर सेक्रेड रिवर्स। फॉर सम टाइम श्री गुरु लिव्ड देयर incognito, sustaining himself by holy alms bhiksha with the intention of uplifting the devotee who offered it to him. As he was accepting bhiksha from the poor, the well-to-do of the place spoke light of him. As the sun continues to shine bright and cause daylight even when hidden behind the clouds, and as musk continues to give out its perfume even when it is conceived in a box, it was impossible for the Lord's divine attributes to be hidden from the folk for long. One day, the Lord went to the threshold of a poor Brahmin for alms. There he saw a very old barren she-buffalo and asked the lady of the house for its milk. The housewife said, "Sir, we have been using this buffalo to carry loads, for it's barren and it does not yield milk." Sri Nrisimha Saraswati laughed and said, "Mother, do not tell me lies." Finding no other way, she fetched a vessel and milked the buffalo, just to show the master that her words were true. Lo, milk flowed plentiful from its udders. Amazed at the strange transformation in the creature, she boiled the milk and offered it to the Lord. The latter drank it with gusto and left for his abode on the banks of the river. The master of the house, having heard of the powers of the Lord's words, at once proceeded to the Sangama along with his wife, worshipped him and received his blessings. The servants in the Brahmin's house came the next morning and were amazed to see the old barren buffalo yielding milk. The news flashed across the land and reached the ruler of that region. The latter ascertained it from the Brahmin and visited the hermitage of the Lord along with his royal retinue. He then approached Sri Guru and prostrated to his feet. Even at the very sight of the Holy One's divine form, the king's heart was fired with devotion. As tears of joy and love trickled down his cheeks, he submitted in a quivering voice, "Sir, I am your humble slave. May you bless and protect me." The Lord said, "O Prince, I am a sannyasi. I live and move about in this wilderness and survive by begging food from others. Why have you, a wealthy and powerful prince, come to me? What can I do for you?" The chief said, "Sir, you are the Supreme Spirit, just sporting in a human form and not really a common mortal. I request you to grace my child and sanctify it." Sri Guru acceded to the request. Sat in the royal palanquin and set out. The chief personally served him, held the royal umbrella over Sri Guru's head and fanned him. As the royal processions moved on, the royal attendants sounded drums and trumpets all along the way. The chief walked by the side of the palanquin as one among the royal attendants. Pious Brahmins chanted the Vedas, while the heralds loudly proclaimed the progress of the Lord of spiritual wealth to the town. People hailed the Lord all along the way. Thus the pageant reached the western gate of the chief township. As the palanquin passed a little inside the gate, Sri Guru noticed a cruel Brahmana Rakshasa, a wicked and powerful spirit, on the top of a peepal tree. At the very sight of Sri Guru, the ferocious spirit was becalmed. At once he got down from the tree, rendered homage to Sri Guru and submitted, "Lord, pray uplift me from this abominable state of existence." The Lord of Divine Mercy put his right hand on the spirit's head in blessing. At once the spirit attained a visible human form. Sri Guru said to him, "My son, if you take a dip at the Sangama, you will attain liberation at once." The spirit prostrated to Sri Guru and took the bath. He immediately left his physical body and attained liberation. The chieftain, amazed at the power of the Lord's blessing, and glorified him and led the palanquin into the town. He immediately raised a mutt monastery and lodged Sri Guru in it. Later, the chief worshipped the divine master every day, served him, and thereby he eventually transcended the terrible ocean of misery. Yielding to the persistent pleadings and devotion of the chief, the Lord stayed on at the place. Every day He used to perform his daily rituals at the mutt, take his bath at the holy Sangama, and despite the treaties of the chief to the contrary, lived by begging in the outskirts of the town. At that time, there lived a learned Brahmin by name Trivikrama Bharati in the neighboring village of Kumasi. He learned of the ways of Sri Guru from hearsay and criticized him as a sannyasi, fallen by transgressing the ideal standard of life of true renunciation. For it is enjoined in the scriptures that a sannyasi should not live under the protection and patronage of a chief. The omniscient Guru knew the inmost thoughts of Trivikrama Bharati. One day he said to the chief, "At Kumasi, there lives a sannyasi by name Trivikrama Bharati. He has been berating me for many ways. I have to go and set him right." The chief was pleased at his words and begged his permission to accompany him. He then summoned all the pomp and procession of Sri Guru, for Sri Guru seated him in the royal palanquin and proceeded to Kumasi. Trivikrama Bharati was a learned sannyasi and an ardent devotee of Lord Nrisimha, the man-lion avatar. On that day, when he sat for his daily meditation, the Lord did not grant him his mystic vision as he usually did. Trivikrama was deeply disappointed and with a yearning heart prayed, "O thou ocean of mercy, the Lord of thy devotees, Lord Narasimha, why am I not able to enjoy thy blessed presence today? Lord, bless me with it." After he meditated for a long time, he heard a voice from within telling him that the Lord is on the banks of the holy river. He immediately proceeded there through the yogic power of Sri Guru, who had already arrived and encompassed at the place. He saw a large gathering of sannyasis. At first he fainted. When he came to his senses, he again saw the same large congregation of sannyasis. Then Sri Guru addressed the dazzled ascetic, "Trivikrama, I am the sannyasi whom you have been vilifying in the pride of your spiritual accomplishments and learning as a hypocrite and a fallen one. Just now I have tested you. It is evident that you are a devotee of Lord Nrisimha and you are well versed in the Dharma Shastra, the code of holy life. Yet, if you are indeed a true renunciate, tell me what you have renounced. How can one whose soul is perturbed by attachment to fame and pride of learning and hatred ever be a sannyasi? I have indeed come here to learn of the attributes of a hypocrite, of a sannyasi, by seeing you. O learned one, reflect deeply upon this and you will know the truth." By the grace of Lord Narasimha, Trivikrama Bharati was humbled. He said, "O Lord, overwhelmed by your yogic power, I am unable to find words for my profound experience. O ocean of mercy, thou self-controlled one, may you protect me. I have realized that the religious merit of my long life meditation has earned for me this meeting with your holiness. You are indeed the Lord on whom I meditate. I seek your refuge. May you pardon my misdeeds." Pleased with the candor and newfound humility and repentance of Trivikrama Bharati, Sri Guru granted him the sight of his real divine form. Trivikrama was able to see the king and his retinue that accompanied him, but could not stand the glory of the Lord's presence. He saw the king fanning him like a humble servant. It was indeed the cosmic form of the Guru that he saw. Sri Nrisimha Saraswati then said, "Trivikrama, I have granted you the blessed vision of my divine form, which cannot be attained even through prolonged cultivation of mystic vision, for I am pleased with your devout practice of dhyana." The next moment, the humbled sannyasi once again saw the mortal form of Sri Guru in front of him, emerging from the mystic vision. Trivikrama sang in praise of the Lord, "O thou spirit of the universe, indeed I haven't meditated on you with a heart, body, or mind that are pure enough. I even vilified you, yet you have graced me and I am blessed indeed. You have granted me the vision of your cosmic form, Vishwarupa, which was vouched to Arjuna of yore. O Hari, I am drifting away in the ocean of ignorance. Pray carry me in the back of the wisdom to the shore of true being." The Lord assured him, "Stay here and you shall transcend ignorance through wisdom and attain the ultimate goal." Again, the Lord returned to his monastery with all the retinue, and there he expounded the path of Karma Yoga to his devotees. Chapter 12 completed. Om Dram Dattatreyaya Namaha.